Days after his indictment, former U.S. President Donald Trump is rallying his supporters to make contributions to his 2024 presidential bid. Trump is expected to be arraigned, fingerprinted, and photographed at a Manhattan courthouse Tuesday as he becomes the first former U.S. president to face criminal charges. Analysts have said Trump will try to turn his indictment in his hush money case to his advantage by stoking anger among his core supporters.
Our movement is about making your life better and putting you first. So I don't want you to incur any financial costs that you can't afford. But if you're doing well because all of the things that I've done have brought you wealth and prosperity, or at least you're extremely comfortable, it would be really great if you could contribute to our campaign. In just a couple of years, our country is going to be richer, stronger, and greater than ever before. But that's only if we win in 2024. Otherwise, our country will continue to fail. Our country will be a disaster.
A clean criminal record is not among the criteria the U.S. Constitution sets for who is eligible to be president. This means any indictment or conviction would not bar Trump from running for the presidency. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. set to attend the coronation of King Charles III next month. This was confirmed by Philippine Ambassador to the UK, Teodoro Locsin Jr. The invitation was only extended to the president and his wife, First Lady Liza Araneta Marcos. The coronation of King Charles III will take place at Westminster Abbey on May 6th. The event is expected to gather world leaders, diplomats, and royals from all over the world. Justice Secretary Remulla also reveals former Negros Oriental Governor Pride Henry Teves has put out feelers to speak to authorities. The former official, the brother of lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr., is also implicated in the killing of his successor. Remulla says they have started looking into Teves' phone records and bank transactions after filing a waiver.
Henry Pride Teves knows what this is all about. He has made feelers to speak to us. And we will act accordingly. Gumamit na siya ng intermediaries para makausap rin.
Philippine authorities claim they are at the tail end of the search for justice for slain Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo. Interior Secretary Benhur Avalos says all 12 suspects in the crime have been accounted for, including one who died during an encounter with government forces on March 5th. The remaining 11 suspects are under the custody of the National Bureau of Investigation.
Ito ang mensahe ng ating mahal na presidente. Sa kanyang panahon talaga, talagang lilitisin po natin talagang lahat ng krimen. Magsasanib persa po. This is ang tinatawag nating whole of the nation approach. Asahan niyo po yan. We are confident that with all the pieces of evidence at hand, our pursuit for justice is within our sight.
The Defense Department, meanwhile, assures residents of Negros Oriental, government forces will continue monitoring the province to ensure their safety.
Ang DND at ang Armed Forces po ay patuloy na nandito upang magbigay ng suporta at sundin ang direktiba ng ating presidente at ang ating task force commander tungo sa ating minimiting justisya para sa pamilya ng Governor Degamo at ng mamamayan ng Negros Oriental. Rest assured that the Armed Forces of the Philippines is always here with the DOJ and the DND in order to resolve other cases.